In recent years, distributed denial of service, DDoS, attacks have become a significant threat to businesses and organizations worldwide. Attackers use various tactics, techniques, and procedures to overload servers with traffic, making websites or services unavailable to all users. One of the techniques used by cybercriminals is amplification and reflection DDoS attacks. A specific type of amplification attack called CLDAP reflection has been widely used since 2016. DDoS reflection has the property of hiding the real source of the attack from the victim, as the traffic is reflected through third-party servers, but there is another more important reason why attackers love it: its amplification effect. Most of the protocols used for reflection also allow attackers to trigger large responses using small queries. This means that attackers can amplify the amount of traffic they could otherwise generate. A typical 1 gigabyte per second attack is now 10 gigabytes per second, or even sometimes 50 to 100 gigabytes per second, depending on the botnet generating the attack. CLDAP stands for Connectionless Lightweight Directory Access Protocol. It is an RFC used by various devices and servers to access Active Directory services over local or public networks. LDAP, its Transmission Control Protocol, TCP, counterpart, is the connection-oriented version of the User Datagram Protocol, UDP, CLDAP. This attack vector is a type of DDoS attack that exploits the protocol's weaknesses to overwhelm a target network with traffic. With this attack, the hackers send a large number of spoofed CLDAP requests to open servers on the internet. Usually, these DNS servers then respond to the spoofed requests, sending a much larger amount of data to the target network than was originally sent by the attacker. This amplification effect can result in a massive influx of data overwhelming the target network, rendering it inaccessible to legitimate users. A CLDAP reflection DDoS attack works in three stages: reconnaissance, spoofing, amplification. Reconnaissance: attackers search for IP addresses of open servers that respond to CLDAP requests. This is usually done using automated tools that scan the internet for vulnerable servers. Most are discovered to be open DNS resolvers. Spoofing: the attacker sends a large number of spoofed CLDAP requests to the open servers, making it appear as though the requests are coming from the target network. Amplification: the open servers respond to the spoofed requests, sending a much larger amount of data to the target network than was originally sent by the attacker. This amplification factor, 56 to 100 times the original request, can result in a massive influx of bandwidth and data overwhelming the target's IP infrastructure. Now that they have performed the minimum three stages above, the denial of service attacks are easy to orchestrate. Simply launching a script, they have the source IP addresses of the open CLDAP servers, they have the victim's IP address for the targeted endpoint and destination port, and now they can begin their attack campaign. Over the years, cybersecurity experts have tracked the use of these attack vectors, and average attack size ranges from 1 gigabyte per second to 100 gigabytes per second. Forwarding rates have been recorded anywhere from 1 million packets per second to 100 million packets per second, giving CLDAP a respectable amplification factor. How do you protect against the CLDAP attack? There are several steps you can take to protect your network from a CLDAP reflection DDoS attack. Network administrators will have to disable the CLDAP protocol. If you do not use the LDAP or CLDAP protocol, it is recommended that you disable it on all devices and servers facing the internet to prevent attackers from exploiting its weaknesses. Network administrators will also have to implement access control lists, ACLs. ACLs can be used to restrict access to CLDAP servers, limiting ingress access to a number of open servers that can be exploited by attackers. And of course, as we've touched base on before, investing in DDoS protection services. Using DDoS mitigation services can detect and stop DDoS attacks, including CLDAP reflection DDoS, before they can reach your network. Regularly patching and updating your systems can help prevent attackers from exploiting known vulnerabilities. Monitoring network traffic can help detect unusual activity and allow you to take action before an attack occurs. Limiting the number of ingress or egress requests and responses can reduce the likelihood for these CLDAP or LDAP servers to be overwhelmed. Thank you for taking the time to dig into one of the most notorious denial-of-service attack methods, LDAP, and the best way to protect yourself from it. We hope this video helps you bring better security to your platform. Don't forget to drop a like on this video and leave a comment. Your feedback is appreciated.